About 6 years ago, I saw this YouTube video of a flying ghost, and ever since, I've wanted to make one myself. Let me show you the video. Just look how awesome that thing looks in the air. I think I can do it a little bit differently though. So in this video, I'm going to actually make my own flying Dementor. My Dementor will hopefully have these four key features. One, I want it to look like a Dementor from Harry Potter, because those actually fly and they're pretty spooky. Two, I want the Dementor to be close to life size. Three, the third requirement seems kind of obvious, but I'm gonna write it down because it actually needs to fly. Four. Now the fourth and final requirement is that it needs to have a live camera feed from the perspective of the Dementor fed to a goggle system that I can wear and see so that I can hide in the bushes and scare the neighbors even better. Now that we have the requirements, let's do some planning to see how we can make a life-size flying one of these a reality. So first we're going to need a basic frame. And I'm going to make this a bicopter, so I'm just going to add two motors and propellers here. Then we'll put like a spooky head on here and maybe some arms with some spooky hands. Then we can find some black cheesecloth material to drape over it to give it that flowing effect when it's flying. Now that we have a basic plan, let's go make this thing real. And I promise you, it's going to look better than this drawing. The flying part of the Dementor consists of these main components. I'm using just square wooden dowels because they're cheap, they're easy to source, and they're really easy to work with. The next part are the motors and propellers. So these are just like what you'd see in an RC airplane. There's nothing real special about them. Next you have the ESCs, or the electronic speed controllers. And these are the same type that you'd see in a racing drone. And we need that high performance to get it more stable in flight. Next we have the servos, which control the tilt of the motor. And I spent a little bit more on these because the metal gear helps them be a little bit more resilient, and the digital means that they react faster to my inputs. Next we have the autopilot, and this is the brains of the operation. I happen to have this one sitting around for years just waiting for it to go into the right project. So this has accelerometers and gyros so that it can tell how it's oriented and how it's rotating in 3D space. To power the Dementor, we're just using standard RC lithium polymer batteries. Finally, we have the tilt mechanism, which I designed and 3D printed myself. The tilt mechanism comes in three parts. It has this green part, which is the motor mount. It has this black part, which is the pivot that holds the motor to the wooden dowel. And then it has this servo mount, which holds a servo to the wooden dowel as well. Now there's a bolt that goes through here and mounts this green part directly to the servo. And that means that it's direct drive, so it has very little slop. We have the basic frame completed. All the electronics are put together, but it's missing something. Let's see here. Haha, that's better. Now, of course, for Halloween, it'll be a little scarier than this. Sometimes the weather doesn't agree for your maiden flight, but we're gonna try it anyway. This might be a terrible idea. Woo! All right, so we had our first failure. That was pretty bad. It was too windy. We'll have to put some new props on it and try it again. I think we'll have to wait for it to be a little bit calmer.
A few moments later.
I'm only sort of nervous here. Give this another try. Woohoo! Oh, oh, oh. We're a little unstable. Oh man, I'm so relieved that this thing flies. Getting it up in the air in that maiden flight means that this is going to be possible. So we can move on to the next step where we deck it out and make it look like an actual Dementor. And I have some decorations here. But before we do that, I do need to tweak it a little bit. These propellers don't add enough thrust, so I'm gonna have to swap it out with some bigger, more powerful propellers. And hopefully we'll be able to carry all the decorations that we're gonna put on it. I just finished the wiring for the first person view video camera to see if I get a live feed back, and we'll be able to fly it remotely with that live feed. Let's plug it in and see if it works. Oh yeah. That's great. Why don't you take a look? Okay, so I'm at the point in the project that's the most frustrating. I've done all the math, I've put it all together, and it doesn't have enough thrust to fly. With the decorations that didn't weigh that much, I put the mask on for the skeleton and I had to take it off because it didn't have enough thrust to lift off the ground. Without the mask, it weighs about 3 pounds. These motor and propellers each should produce over 2 pounds of thrust. So that should give me 4 pounds of thrust. I should have an extra pound of thrust. And each motor should be drawing about 200 watts. But let me show you what's happening right now. So I've connected this power meter here that will tell me how much power the whole thing is drawing when I throttle it up. You can tell without the motors running, I'm drawing about 3.5 watts. That's powering the video transmitter, the autopilot here, the receiver, the servos, which aren't doing anything right now. But let's power it up and I'll show you what's happening. So even at full throttle, you could see I was drawing just under 300 watts and about 26 amps. I'm missing about 100 watts here and about another 10 amps, which should give me that extra pound of thrust to get this off in the air. So where is that 100 watts? I think one of the things is that the autopilot that I'm using leaves a little bit of headroom on the top of the throttle so that it has some maneuverability so that you're not ever maxed out. That way, even if you have full throttle up, it'll still have some headroom to be able to stay level. Now, I think that there shouldn't be another 25% power left on the table. Maybe. I looked at the manual and I think that there's a procedure that I skipped that calibrates the throttle. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that and see if that gets me any more power. That actually gave us less power. Well, that totally didn't work. It's back to the drawing board. Let's see if we can build something quickly and get it up in the air in time. So instead of this, we're gonna do a tricopter. We're gonna have three motors. Let's put the head right here, and maybe we can have the arms like this. And then have the flowy material like that. I'm back in my workshop. I'm ready to break this thing down because I'm gonna have to take it apart. I can reuse the tilt mechanism that I built for the tricopter, but for the most part, I'm gonna have to completely rebuild the frame. Now, it's only 2 days till Halloween, so I have to bust my butt to get this done. Straight to it. Flies! All right, we've got this magnificent Dementor ready to fly. Now we just gotta wait for the trick-or-treaters.
Is that a Death Eater?
Dementor! Dang, that was a lot of work, but oh man, it looked great in the air, which made it all worth it. Everybody that was out trick-or-treating at the time was just in awe seeing that thing fly around, and I heard people saying, oh, is that real? Oh, that's so cool. I had a couple people dressed up as Harry Potter who were like, oh, it's a Dementor, oh, you know, it was great. That made it all worth it because that was a lot of work. Hopefully you like this project and you'll come back for more. The best way you can show your support is by subscribing, liking, or following, turning on notifications. You can find me on all the different social media platforms, and hopefully I'll see you next time for some more fun projects.